If you want to increase the return on investment for your ads, but are unsure how a funnel can help, this video is for you. In a nutshell, the Facebook Ads funnel is a model for visualizing, tracking, and analyzing the business impact of your ad campaigns. It helps you deliver targeted ads to potential customers and improve the conversion rate of campaigns. Typically, the ads funnel has three components: the top of funnel, tofu, the middle of the funnel, mofu, and the bottom of the funnel, bofu. To illustrate the purpose of ads at different stages, we can use the IADA framework. IADA stands for awareness, interest, desire, and action. At the awareness stage, your target customer has a problem but is not actively looking for a solution. An awareness ad aims to spark curiosity in potential customers and familiarize the audience with your brand. As a result, these ads should be eye-catching and appealing to a broad audience. Once you've got attention, the next step is to generate interest. At this point, the target customer is aware of the problem but hasn't explored any solutions. Your interest ads should describe the core benefits of your product and explain how it works or what it can do for them. Now it's time to show prospects why your solution is better than market alternatives to achieve desire. With desire ads, you must highlight your product's added value, emphasize its problem-solving features, and prove that your product is the best available option. Finally, you need to prompt target customers to take action. Purchase, sign up, etc. At this stage, they have already visited your website and know what you have to offer. So your ads should focus on creating a sense of urgency and utilizing exclusive deals, sign-up discounts, and so on. It's important not to forget about the post-purchase stage of the funnel. These ads encourage customers to buy from you again, upgrade their subscription or product, or be rewarded for loyalty. The goal is to increase customer retention, satisfaction, and repeat purchases. Now, I won't go into detail about how to set up an ads funnel, as we've already covered this topic in another video. Instead, I'll briefly describe the flow of funnel creation so you have a basis for further analysis and optimization. Define your target audience. Segment your audience based on their stage in the buyer journey. Start by dividing them into two groups: cold, top of the funnel, and warm, middle and bottom of the funnel. A cold audience consists of people who have never interacted with your ads before. They could be narrowed down by interests and demographic markers or lookalikes. Let's use a pet insurance company as an example of the interests and demographic markers approach. The company can select interests and topics like pet food, dogs, cats, etc. to target their cold audience on top of relevant demographics like location, age, and gender. Another way is to create a target audience based on the characteristics of your existing customers. This will help maximize your chances of reaching people with the relevant interests, motivations, and problems. This is known as lookalikes. As for the warm audience, it's made up of people who are familiar with your product or service. It includes website visitors, users who converted through your website, and existing customers. You can use Metapixel, Google Analytics 4, and your customer database to obtain this data and create custom audiences in Meta Ads Manager. Set campaign objectives. There are 5 Facebook ad campaign objectives: awareness, traffic, engagement, leads, and sales. In general, your ad objective should match your audience. Awareness objectives are always for the top of the funnel, while traffic, engagement, and leads can be assigned to the middle and bottom of the funnel ads. Create compelling campaigns for each stage of the funnel. For awareness campaigns, the primary goal is to get the cold target customer to stop scrolling and pay attention to your message or offer. So the messaging should be bold, and the ad itself should be eye-catching. Interest campaigns aim to engage the audience and prompt them to learn more about the brand and products. At this stage, we are dealing with a cold or warm audience, people who know at least something about your company or product. For desire, we should emphasize the benefits of your product or service. Our messages will most likely address a warm audience, like those who have visited the website, and retarget prospects who engaged with your previous campaigns. In action campaigns, we focus on engaging a warm audience already familiar with your product. Our approach might include offering a discount on their first purchase, or creating a sense of urgency to encourage immediate action. Let's explore real-life examples of campaigns for each stage. This image is an excellent example of an awareness ad. We can presume the campaign aims to raise brand awareness while introducing the product from a problem-solution perspective. So what makes it good? It clearly outlines the audience's pain, describes the audience's potential triggers. The image itself demonstrates the product and how it solves a problem. The CTA offers an actionable next step, even if purchases are not immediately expected. Provides social proof in the CTA block to establish legitimacy. Now that you've got your customer's attention, you must explain the why behind your product. What does your product or service actually do, and how will it enhance their lives? To achieve this, Topaz Photo AI collaborated with a photography influencer to highlight one of the product's key features. This ad creative demonstrates a key product feature based on a common use case, captures the essence of the solution with a side-by-side comparison, shows an industry expert actively using the product, establishing credibility. The feature's main benefits are briefly elaborated on in the caption. At the desire stage, the audience evaluates the options on the market and looks for the product that best solves their problem. Desire ads should make this process as smooth as possible. They can also recapture leads who interacted with your interest campaigns but didn't take further action. This image ad from ClickUp contains lots of social proof, includes logos from well-known tech review platforms for additional credibility, highlights some helpful and notable product features, summarizes the product purpose and benefit. At the action stage of the funnel, ads are designed to drive purchases. The content of these ads often differs from previous campaigns and focuses on the offer rather than the product benefits, and seeks to instill a sense of urgency. At the post-purchase stage, your Facebook ads should nurture existing customers by offering an enhanced product experience, exclusive deals, and other incentives to strengthen loyalty. To explore this approach, let's return to the loop earplugs we saw in the awareness ad and explore how the company supports the post-purchase stage of the funnel. At this stage, their ad demonstrates that the company paid attention to customer feedback, exemplifies the product improvements, and provides a clear use case, offers a motivation to purchase with a clear CTA. However, creating eye-catching creatives for each stage of the funnel isn't enough for successful Facebook ad campaigns. After setting up your funnel, you will need to track and carefully measure the results of your campaigns. Let's review the most important metrics for each stage of the funnel. At the top of the funnel, you should track impressions, reach, CPM, and ad frequency. Impressions are the total amount of times your audience viewed your ad. The more impressions you receive, the higher your chances of conversion. Reach estimates how many Facebook users have been shown your ad at least once. If impressions and reach are close in number, you are doing great. Cost per mil, CPM, is the amount of money you need to spend to have your ad shown in the feed 1,000 times. A low CPM indicates that you are getting a good return on your investment in terms of impressions. Ad frequency is the approximate number of times someone on Facebook sees your ad. If it's higher than 4, your ad might become annoying, so you should check the campaign settings. At the middle of the funnel stage, we are interested in link clicks, unique link clicks, CPC, and CTR. Link clicks measure the total number of times people click on a link in your ad. This metric is important because it tells you whether your audience is interested in what you have to offer. Unique link clicks are the number of individual Facebook users who clicked on the link in your ad. It helps you gauge how well you attract target customers and convert them into qualified leads. CPC, cost per click, is the average amount you pay for a prospect to click on your ad. It differs from cost per conversion, as it focuses on the cost of acquiring a click rather than the cost to achieve a purchase or sign up. CTR, click-through rate, is the rate at which people click on your ad and end up on your landing page. For the bottom of the funnel stage, we should track conversions, which are meaningful actions taken by prospects after clicking on your ad. These may refer to lead form submissions, sign-ups, checkout initiated, demo requests, subscription upgrades, etc. At this stage, you should definitely focus on finance. Cost per conversion, CPC, assesses the efficiency of your campaign in terms of generating conversions. A high conversion cost indicates that your budget should be adjusted or reallocated. Amount spend is the total amount of money invested in a Facebook ad campaign. The lower it is and the higher your engagement scores, the more cost-effective your ad campaign. ROAS, return on ad spend, measures a campaign's ability to generate revenue. It helps you report on the business impact of individual campaigns and identify the most valuable types. There is also a set of metrics for the post-purchase period. For instance, repeat purchase rate indicates how often a customer buys from you after the first purchase. It is helpful for understanding when to launch a retargeting campaign for existing customers. Customer lifetime value, LTV, refers to the total financial value a customer brings to your business throughout their engagement with your brand. It helps you measure the success of long-term Facebook ads and improves budget allocation. An important note, average CPC, CPM, conversion rates, and other metrics can vary greatly in different industries. Check industry benchmark reports to get a realistic view of your campaign's performance at each funnel stage. Hopefully, you now have a better understanding of different ads metrics. It's time to manage, analyze, and optimize your ads funnel. The most obvious tool for that is Meta Ads Manager. It's the central hub for managing creatives, budgeting, targeting, and other ad campaign activities. However, Meta Ads Manager has several limitations when it comes to data visualization, filtering, and campaign comparison. You can overcome them by using third-party services like Coupler.io. Let me show you a few free Facebook Ads Report templates. This is a dedicated dashboard for tracking and analyzing the results of your Facebook ads campaigns. It's a free template, takes less than 5 minutes to set up, and can be used daily to monitor trends and guide campaign budget allocation. The dashboard shows important funnel metrics like impressions, CPM, and CTR, and has a graph for monitoring campaign frequency. It also allows you to drill into performance by campaign and assess funnel efficiency. There is also a monthly dynamics tab to dive deeper into your funnel campaign results. Analyze clicks by age, gender, or location demographics. This will help you identify the countries and age groups with the highest ROAS to get the most from your budget at each funnel stage. I will leave a link to the dashboard in the description. As a marketer, you likely run ads on different platforms. In this scenario, having a dashboard to track the performance of your cross-channel advertising efforts is a great idea. This PPC multi-channel dashboard template aggregates data from different advertising sources and lets you visualize performance metrics in a simple report. For instance, you can analyze clicks by source and campaign type, compare CPC across channels, keep track of spend amounts, and drill into metrics like impressions, CPM, and CTR for each source. It's an easy way to spot bottlenecks in your PPC marketing funnel and monitor Facebook ad ROI against other channels. You can use this template in Looker Studio, Power BI, Google Sheets, or Tableau. I will leave all the links in the description. Let me also share a few tips on optimizing your Facebook ads campaign. While there is no silver bullet that can transform a boring, frequently skipped ad campaign into a viral sensation, Facebook ads funnel optimization is an ongoing process. Here are a few suggestions for gradual improvement. Test bidding strategies, audiences, and campaign objectives. Play around with campaign setup options in Ads Manager to find the optimal approach for each ad type. Bidding strategies. Meta offers three types of bidding: spend-based, goal-based, and manual. To find the most cost-effective types, you can experiment with different goals and budget amounts. Audiences. Create custom audiences based on past campaign results or existing customer data. Analyze how well they perform against saved or lookalike audiences. Try different campaign objectives. For instance, assign a leads objective to a newsletter sign-up promotion and check how it performs compared to similar campaigns with a traffic objective. Play with ad placements. Instead of defaulting to automatic or newsfeed placements, test ads in Facebook Stories, Messenger, or Reels. Experiment with creatives. While image, short video, and carousel ads often yield the highest results, don't be afraid to experiment with less popular formats. For example, you could try playables for gaming app promotion, or collection ads for an e-commerce product showcase. At the same time, switch up your content to find out what brings the best ROI. Here are a few suggestions for optimizing your creatives. Create infographics to explain the benefits of your product in an easily digestible way. Collaborate with influencers on short video product or service demonstrations. Experiment with humor if it makes sense for your industry or niche. Test videos with an underproduced style with no fancy camera equipment. Focus on authentic, relatable content. Incorporate interactive elements like polls, quizzes, or 360 product views. Pay close attention to landing pages. Let's say you are advertising a SaaS product and want to improve conversions for landing pages corresponding to your funnel ads. What kind of changes could you make? For awareness landing pages, find ways to increase brand visibility and draw attention to your product offering. For instance, if it's a blog post, you could weave a CTA organically into the text or include a sticky banner in the side menu. For interest-generating landing pages, you could experiment with dynamic hero visuals or dedicated blocks that describe product use cases. For desire-oriented landing pages, consider including an FAQ, customer testimonials, and short video case studies to help prospects make decisions faster. For landing pages at the action stage, ensure CTAs are clear and concise. For example, sign up for free. You could also implement a pop-up to encourage discount claims or a chatbot to resolve your prospects' pre-purchase doubts. Additionally, you should ensure brand messaging is consistent across ads and pages. Content is personalized for the target audience, and web pages are optimized for mobile. Leverage a storytelling approach. It's no secret that customers prefer to engage with ads that tell a story. Humans naturally gravitate towards narratives, and we are 22 times more likely to remember stories over facts. So, to optimize engagement and conversions, think of your funnel as a storytelling vehicle. Each stage is an opportunity to connect with your audience on an emotional level. Tofu is where you introduce the audience to the context of your brand story. Your awareness and interest ads hook the target customer and compel them to learn more. Mofu ads provide the audience with the meat of your brand story. The target customer comes to understand what you do, why it's important, and how it can positively impact their reality. Bofu is where you provide closure and emphasize the value of your offering. Post-purchase ads reinforce the key lessons of the story and help customers see the deeper value of your solution. You can find more tips in the other video on our channel. To sum up, why is using and optimizing a Facebook ads funnel crucial? You can run ad campaigns on Facebook without using a funnel. However, if you don't tailor your campaigns to different target audiences, your return on ad spend, ROAS, will likely be lower. On the contrary, adopting a full funnel approach to Facebook advertising offers numerous benefits, including higher conversion rates and return on ad spend, lower ad frequency and reduced ad fatigue, better user experience, a more substantial brand reputation, and increased customer retention. A competitive edge over advertisers who don't take a full funnel approach to Facebook ads. And that's it. Now you know how to create and optimize your Facebook ads funnel. If you have any questions, please ask them down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.